This area of green chemistry is all about how we design the molecules that we use, the materials that we use, in ways that are going to be healthful and sustainable rather than what they have been for the past 200 years, which is depleting, degrading, and toxic. It's a framework for saying that we can design our products and processes so that they're sustainable, using renewable materials, using manufacturing processes that generate less waste and use less toxic substances, having products that aren't of concern for our children or ourselves or our ecosystems. That's what green chemistry is all about. Green chemistry has a way of touching, you know, all sectors and all aspects of society. Certainly the traditional chemical industry, pharmaceuticals, agriculture, materials, energy, automotive, electronics, and on and on. Green chemistry is every bit as applicable to emerging economies as it is to industrialized nations, because this allows people to come at problems differently, using different feedstocks, different ways of transforming things that can be done really anywhere. The only thing more exciting than the achievements of green chemistry so far is the future power and potential of green chemistry. For every product that has been reinvented using the principles of green chemistry, there are perhaps tens or hundreds of products that have yet to be reinvented. And so when we start thinking about the kind of transformative innovations that are possible, the kind of transformative innovations that sustainability requires, that's where green chemistry's future lies.